Hello, family and friends. Welcome to the Woke Nation, our national factual truth, where we feel free to share knowledge and spread the knowledge of factual truth without fear, without favor, and without faint. Yeah. And we also encourage you to live your life and live it well with the knowledge of factual truth. It's very important that you have knowledge of factual truth. And the only way you can get it is through information. You need to know, not believe. Religion and politics want you to believe what the political and religious leaders are saying without proof. What they are saying for their own gain, for their own selfish profit. Because they know if you know the truth, you will not even spend a second of your time to listen to them or to be with them. You will not engage in their campaign. You will not vote them. You will never have anything to do with them. So they keep lying to you and want you to believe it. So, and you see masses, especially the poor masses, because they are void of information. That is, they don't have the tools, the resources it takes to verify what they hear. So they tend to be like accepting whatever that person there says. It must be true. Oh, he's educated and he said that. It's true. I believe him. I believe her. So they're living by faith instead of by fact. And they believe that what they believe is true. So believers believe in belief. They don't believe in truth. They believe in belief. They believe without sin. So they don't have facts. They just believe. And that is their problem. That is why all these criminals you call politicians and religious leaders are taking advantage of them, exploiting them, using them, and making life miserable for them. So that's why I want to share what I titled Lack of Information. So many people keep saying about lack of knowledge. You have to know why there is lack of knowledge. The reason why there is lack of knowledge is because of lack of information, especially the true information. Although some people, they have access to information, but they chose to believe. They chose to ignore the facts. They hear it, but they be like, don't worry about that. Maybe because of the person is coming from. They think you are crazy because they have already been misled to believe. If you don't belong to their club, if you don't belong to their religion, if you don't belong to their cult, you are not worthy to be listened to. And you can never say the truth because you are not of them, of their clique. And you see, even educated people, people you expected that they will verify something and make sound judgment, you see them falling for that nonsense also. You know, people that comes to help them, they despise them, they throw them aside. Say, he's crazy, don't listen to him, I don't listen to him. But you have problem. Your education could not solve your problem. You have problem in your family, that division in your family, that hatred in your family, that death in your family, that sickness in your family, that disease in your family. And that's one of the reasons why, despite your level of education, you are falling for one illiterate because he's a prophet or she's a prophetess. You know, you spend all that years in higher institutions and saying you are learned. Some of you are PhD. You have degrees, you have masters and all that. But you are living like a slave. You are reasoning like a child. You are not reasoning like a grown person, a grown human being, somebody that have been to the four walls of higher institution. All your esquire, all your title you have is just nonsense. All the degrees you have, they're all nonsense. Because you allow faith to rot your brain. You can't use your brain no more. Somebody giving you information that will help you and your generation, you say, who, from which authority? You want to listen to, that's where authority keep lying to you. And you are believing their lies as the truth. Then the illiterates, those you call illiterates that didn't go to school as you did, that don't have your degrees and PhD papers or all the diplomas you have. You say, no. But the solution to your problem is common sense. Common sense will solve your problem. But you allow the papers you have to impede your sense of reasoning, to rob you that ability to reason as human being and make sound judgment. So despite your level of education, you are still stupid. That's what faith makes you. If you are a graduate and you still believe, you still having faith, you say you are living by faith, you're still stupid. You cannot make right judgment because your judgment will be based on what is written by someone you don't know, but because it was forced on people to accept it as the authority, as everybody must accept it. You must live by it. That is what is trending. Then you begin to live by it. You begin to preach it. You begin to spread it as the truth you must live by. And then you are not living by that. You call that person names. You are stupid. Yes, you are a graduate, but you are stupid. You still believe what somebody says without your own proper investigation. Ask for more information. Believers don't ask for more information. They believe what they heard. And they settled. They read one book. They didn't even read the book cover to cover. They just cherry-pick it or use their daily devotion that their general overseer or the authority wrote, you know, using the guidelines that someone else laid down. Now they use it to pride that they have known. Oh, I know the God myself. Well, how do you know the God yourself? Because a book says so. Not that that God says so. You are still stupid. That's what makes you a stupid person. That you didn't attend any school doesn't make you a stupid person. No. You can be educated, but you are stupid. You are not intelligent. You don't consider intelligence. And you begin to play with people's intelligence out of your grammar. Nonsense you learn from school. Because you know how to put words together in the language that you can't even use to feed yourself. Or to take care of you. Or to solve your problem. Especially solve your problem. Yet you brag. You see them, educated people, they go to native doctor or they go to pastors looking for the solution to their problem. Yet they believe there is God. They believe this God loves them. This God cares about them. This God sent him. So they believe all the nonsense that the preachers and all the nonsense that the native doctors that believe in one God or the other are saying. Use your brain. When last time I went to native doctor, what he was saying, I said, listen, I know all these things. But I came here for a reason, to show that, listen, I have tested religion and I have tested African spirituality. So I know all of them are the same bullshit, believe. And when I open my mouth and start, they will be wondering, wow, really? Oh, yes, it's common sense. And those of you that believe in nonsense because you don't have enough information, you believe in spirituality because you don't have enough information, you believe in religion because you don't have enough information. Think what you call spiritual. Don't you see some grass? Immediately you touch them, they shrink or they cover up naturally. Don't you see marijuana? You smoke it or you eat it or you cook with it, it gets you high. It's not spiritual anything, it's natural. Don't you see what you call what is the chameleon, the animal called chameleon. You see any color he sees and spend little time with that color, it turns to that color. It's not spiritual anything, it's not God anything, it's nature. It's natural. Just as you are natural, you are not spiritual. Because you don't understand your dream, you don't understand your vision, you don't understand your revelation, you say God. So you are God, your ignorance is your God. Because you don't know, you say it's God. But when you know, you begin to say, are you sure? Are you sure? But you can verify it. But you don't want to verify it. But the one you're supposed to ask, are you sure? You didn't say, are you sure? Because they call God. They say, no, it's God. You haven't seen this God. Lack of information. See what is happening today. You see a lot of black people, Africans, you see them saying that black people hate themselves. Because of, no, I say, this people, what is, it is slave mentality. Because white people are giving you something. Now, you think they love themselves more than you love yourselves? You think black, white people care about themselves? People that enslaved you? Before they came enslave us, they enslaved themselves. They hated themselves. They still hate themselves. That's why they made weapons of mass destruction, killing themselves like animals. Our ancestors, we black people never have the mind to be killing themselves. Even though they are poor, they rather be having more children being poor than killing anyone. Can't you think? But you believe the lies. They tell you your ancestors were killing twins. You believe. And the people that tell you this are people that kill your ancestors. People that came with weapon, kill your ancestors, enslave you, and still having power master over you with weapon. But you keep believing their lies. That's why they keep saying you are stupid. No matter what you do, you can speak all you want, you can rally all you want. They know they still have you by the balls. There's nothing you can do. You don't know yourself. That's why you said, oh, we hate ourselves. Who taught you that self-hate? You don't think about that. Now, when you tell them that Christianity, Islam, Judaism taught us self-hate, you say it's not true. Because it is the religion they force on you. That's why they say you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your being. That means you hate yourself. For you to love God with all your strength, with all your heart, with all your might, with everything you have, that means you hate yourself. If you care, or let me use the word, if you love yourself as you're supposed to, you will not love God with anything you have. Because we know you are the real God that provides for you. You are the real God that keeps yourself alive. And you begin to love your fellow human beings, because without your fellow human beings, you won't be here today. You had parents, not God. Your parents is the reason why you were born, not God. God did not create you at any time. God has no such ability. God does not exist. We're not saying it, well, maybe saying it smoothly. No, we have been saying it with all boldness. God does not exist. God is useless in reality. You exist and you are useful in reality. And you can prove it by having your own child. You can prove it the way you walk, the way you do things to provide for yourself, to provide for your family. You are the God of yourself. You are the God of your family. If you are doing anything for yourself or for your family, God is not doing anything. But they tell you, give thanks to God. And you stupidly accept that. And giving thanks to God you have not seen. God that have not shown up. Because you lack information. And you don't consider information you hear. You just keep believing blindly. You have to consider those informations so that you can live your life well. You see, you have that educated person in your family, some of them living abroad, but they still believe the nonsense that even the poor ones believe, the ones they say they know better than. No, you don't. Those illiterates are better than you that is educated, because those illiterates are, at least, you know, they don't have access to the information you have. But you are living in abroad. You know, you have the money to do your own research, but you refuse to do that. But you keep believing and you keep suffering. Some of you living in abroad and somebody in Africa is asking you to send money to be giving to pastor to be praying for you, praying for your family problem. And you believe that. Where was this God you prayed of before you run away from your village and come to abroad? Or somebody came and married you and take you abroad? Where was this God? When your family has been so, God did not show up. But he said, no, God, God's time is the best. God answers prayer. You lack information, not knowledge yet. You have to get well informed. So you that is saying that black people hate themselves, you are not well informed. You don't. You share the picture where white people are pushing themselves up and black people are pulling themselves down. That's nonsense. That's white propaganda. That's self-hate. When they tell you to, if you want to be a disciple of Jesus, you must hate your parents, hate your siblings, and your life. If you don't do that, you are not worthy. And you said, oh, we separate. No, that one that taught you that, because that is in their gene. It is in the white people to hate themselves, and they taught you to hate yourself. But it's not in black people to hate themselves. That's why they have cities without walls. They have tribes without war. No boundary. They know, okay, water is the boundary. That's it. But they weren't building anything to stop other people from coming. But you see, when these wicked ones is in their gene, they begin to put up those borders. Sometimes if you want to cross, they shoot you there, you die. And they will tell you that you are the one that is bad. Oh, now, and this, let me talk also about my people, the Igbo people. I see stupid ones among our brethren saying that Igbos hate themselves. In Nigeria, go do your own investigation. There's no tribe in Nigeria that is as good as Igbo people. None. As Hausa people, they will tell you. As Yoruba people that are wise, they will tell you the truth. Igbo people didn't need to travel abroad to become millionaires. They made themselves in their own land. They build things. They manufacture things. They have go to every happening business places in Nigeria, whether in the north, in the east, or in the west. Go there in Lagos, Abuja, or Kano, or anywhere, or in the east. Who are the people doing the business? Go to the Nigerian port. Who are the people importing all those containers? Most of them are illiterate. They never attend any university. But you see them doing well in business. Because originally we were doing it, every family have handwork, have something that they have that they inherit from their parents. They continue. Before in Igbo land, you cannot just marry because you say you think you have an erection. You are of age now. You want to marry? No, you will show what you can, how you can take care of yourself, your wife, and your children. If you want to marry 10, can you take care of them? It's not easy to in Igbo land for you to marry before. No, not now. It is easy. Now you don't pay. You don't pay the main thing you used to pay before. Because you have to marry to many people before you say you're married. Now you just pay bride price, you take the woman. It was not like that before. You are poor, you don't even think about getting married. The only way a poor man will marry is if they see he's poor, but he get land, the inherited land. Then a woman will manage him to marry him, to produce children. That's it. Not that they weren't fucking, of course. You don't need marriage to fuck. Marriage is slavery too. You cannot afford marriage, so you can afford fucking. You don't need to pay to fuck. All you need to fuck is agreement. But you hear Igbo people opening their stinking mouth, especially those that are rooting against somebody like Nnamdi Kanu or Biafra. You see them talking nonsense, Igbos hate themselves. You need to go and learn about Yoruba people, how they kill themselves in their villages. You don't know that, but you're talking. Go to Hausa, and you know one Alhaji can be ruining the lives of everyone in the whole state, not even village, the whole state, and all of them will be bowing. But Igbo people will not like that. Igbo man might bow to you today, but after some time we say, you know what, I refuse to bow anymore. Who are you? When Igbo man asks you, who are you? You defeat me. You know you have lost all the respect in this world he's supposed to give to you. It's lack of information. That's why you are saying black people don't love themselves. Black people hate themselves. You lack information. It is lack of information. That's why you say Igbo people hate themselves. You lack information. It's lack of information. That's why you say there is God. Lack of information. That's why you believe Jesus died for you and is coming to take you away. Lack of information. Begin to do your own research. Use YouTube. Use Google. Even the Facebook you have. Think outside the box of your religion. Begin to listen to people that have knowledge of it. I am the evidence that God cannot do you anything bad. God cannot touch you. God cannot bless you. You are the one. Look at me. Any God that say he can do anything to you, direct that God to me. I will kill that God so that you'll be free. Understand that when you say you believe, you are sick. I can heal you. When you say you fear God, you are sick. I can deliver you. That's why I'm here, to give you information. I daily give informations free of charge. Now I come to work. See? So I'm still young to work. I'm not depending on anyone. I'm not a thief like your political leaders and your religious leaders. All I need is for you to wake up. That's my mission, period. Wake up and live your life. Okay? And you will see how life is easy. Life is good and life is sweet. God, didn't it?